sure how you want to. Yeah. Glory to God. We don't want to miss this. Thank you so much. Thank you, friends and family, for coming out for the dedications. We praise the Lord for that. Glory to God. Would you bow your hearts? Just open in a word of prayer. Can we do that? Yeah. Father, we so love you. We so thank you and adore you, God, this morning. Thank you for this incredible opportunity, Lord, to dedicate little ones back unto you. Lord, to walk and to raise these little ones, Father, in the eyes of the Lord, Father, that you would bless them and their families, Father, from now forever. Father, we praise you this morning. Thank you for every visitor, God, who's come out. Father, we pray that your Holy Spirit just makes them feel right at home. Holy Spirit, have your divine way this day as we bless your name in all that we say and do. Glory to God. Pastor Lori, it's in your hands, girl. Glory to God. Give the Lord a praise. Yes.
We are so excited. This is one of my favorite times, is when we get to have the blessing and the opportunity to pray a blessing and just shower in love on all of the babies and the children today. So if I can get everybody to take your seats, please. If you're still here for the first service, if I can get you to go ahead and have your seats as we're getting ready to do this and honor those that are getting ready at this time to just be loved on. So let's see, as I'm looking around the room, let's see, all of my babies here, but that's okay. Let's have everybody come on up front that is planning to have the baby dedication, and we'll get started. Come on up, guys. Yeah. Just like we talked about in class, everybody come on up. Don't be shy. That's right. Don't be shy. Yeah. Donna, I think your family was over this way a little bit more. Come on over this way. There you go. Yeah. Guys, come on down. We'll just scoot on down. I think we got everybody. Awesome. Don't they look great, guys? I'll get out of the way. This is a beautiful time to just celebrate what the Lord is doing in family life. And if you were here in the first service, Pastor got to prophesy and pray over Gabe Bridges and Brian Bridges are expecting, and they're getting ready to have another beautiful little baby. And the first service was off the hook, and in that time, there was just a prophetic word that came forth, and he got to bless and pray over Gabe, and it's just, what a perfect day to be able to do that. One a day that the Lord is also bringing forth the babies and the children to just pray a dedication over it. I think that when I think of what this day represents and what it means, is you guys have such an amazing opportunity before you, is to teach and love and to train and develop and mentor the babies and the children of today. You know, you look at, where we are now and the stage of life that we're in now and just everything that is going on in the world. But you get the opportunity to just love on these kids. The word says to train up a child in the way they will go. And they will never forget. They will never step away. And that's as a parent, as a godparent, as a grandparent, as a great-grandparent. We got it all up here today. you get that opportunity to teach and just mentor and be the example before the children. That's what the day is really about. You know, we get and understand that in a moment we've got some staff members that are going to come up and they're going to pray an actual blessing over the baby and the children. But we get the opportunity as pastors to share as they're praying, to pray a general prayer over the parents and the godparents and the aunts and the uncles and all of you, because you know that it takes a village. It takes all of us. It takes family to just pray and bless and to teach and change and be an example to the parents. How many of you know in today's society, it's more challenging than when it was when I was had my little ones that are now big ones and my grandchildren are all like this. It's a challenging world that we live in. But we're up to the challenge because he's a good, good, good father. He's a good, good, good father. And I think these babies are beautiful. Pastor, go ahead and come on up. I know you have some things, and I'm going to ask those that are part of the staff that are going to be praying a special blessing over the children, if you will go come on up and stand behind your designated family. That would be great, too. So come on up, guys.
Cool. We good?
Yep, go ahead.
Cool. I look at this group. It's pretty amazing. You have to understand, the first 20 years of pastor, and I never had this many people in a whole church. So it's pretty neat. But it's exciting to see what God's doing. And I think about these guys, you know, and we have little ones that we're going to dedicate, new babies. We have some that are a little bit older, and that's really cool. But I'll challenge you with a couple of thoughts if I can. I look at these kids. Think with me for a minute what Jesus says. Suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not. Why? For of such is the kingdom of heaven. Right? He said, except you become as a little child, you'd no wise enter into the kingdom of heaven. And we see these kids and their innocence and their blessing. And I stop and I think about, man, how significant that is. There's a man that shows up. Jesus is on the Mount of Transfiguration, Moses, Elijah. I think some of you know the story with Peter, James, and John. He comes down off the mountain and there's a man at the bottom of the hill. And remember what it was? His son was possessed. And what was the first words that Jesus said? Bring the child to me. Why? Because when we bring the children to him, everything changes. I think it's so significant that you guys would all be standing here together today. What are you doing? You're actually bringing your child to Jesus. We're bringing our children to the Lord, and we realize dedication, the whole concept of dedication starts with Hannah, who in the temple, what'd she do? She brought Samuel, right? Come on. She prays for Samuel in the temple because she's childless and she's barren and she wants a child. And God gives her the very desire of her heart. Why? Because God loves us and wants to give us the desires of our heart. And in the midst of that, when she gets the blessing, what's she do? She brings him back to the temple, right? And she brings him before Eli and says, this is the child that I prayed for, because Eli prophesied over that child would come forth. And it did. Now, the difference is she leaves the baby. You are taking yours home. We can't be raising your kids here. Okay? Okay. That's okay. Some days you're thinking, maybe just for a weekend. No, okay. Okay. But the idea behind it is that she dedicates that child. She realizes, man, this is the gift of God. How many understand children are, the scripture says children are the heritage of the Lord, right? It's the gift of God. They're God's gift to us, man. The whole future of the world lies in these kids, this generation. It's exciting to think about what that really offers. And so as you stand here today, man, I'm going to charge you parents and even the grandparents that are standing with you. Lori said something a little while ago. It takes a whole lot of us to raise children. And I realize, man, there's challenges with all that. But every one of us plays a significant role. I may not be Keegan's dad, I'm his grandfather, but I still have a voice in his life. You understand that? Over and over, we have a voice in the lives of these kids, and it's absolutely powerful because dedication is not as much about the child as it is about the parents. We're actually presenting the child before the Lord, and we're actually saying, God, we acknowledge that this is a gift from you, and the gift that you've given us today, we give back. And we say, Lord, the child is yours. We present that child alive before the Lord and say, God, he's not my child, he's yours. She's not my daughter, she's your daughter first. You've given us stewardship, but you possess ownership. And we will steward the gift of God well. And that's really what you're saying today as you bring these children before the Lord. You're saying, God, we will use every possible way to train and direct our children in the ways of God. We'll use the auspices of the church. We'll teach them from your word. We'll steward all that you've given us to give to them. And we'll do it to the very best of our knowledge and ability. That's a big deal. We're actually saying, God, on this day, we are covenanting with you, with our child, to say we will teach and train this child in the ways of the Lord. To me, that's a very, very big deal. And I challenge you, man, this is a promise you're making to God today. He doesn't take promises lightly. Actually, the scripture in Ecclesiastes chapter 4 says it's better not to vow a vow than to vow a vow before God and break it. Today you're making a promise with God. We will teach and train our children in the ways of the Lord. And so that's a big deal. So what I'd like to do right now is ask, I know there's some folks that are praying with each of you, and I'm going to ask them if they would to just come and put hands on your babies just for a moment. Can you do that? Put your hands on the babies. What's that? Yeah. And the children as well. Yeah. Yeah, right, because they're not just all babies. Okay. Yeah. And they can be incredibly docile or incredibly squirmy, and it happens all that time that way, and that's okay. But it's, you can take them. Come on. Okay. But there's a place, and watch, this is a big deal. Because as we lay our hands on these children, we're asking God, God, you put your hand there. As I begin to pray over these kids, I'm going to pray collectively over all of them, but I'd like for those of you that have been significantly chosen to pray over those children to begin to do that as we start to pray, and I'd just like for Pastor Lori and I just to come by and pray over each of them as well. Is that okay? Okay. We're going to do this. Okay. Yeah. I saw this one last night. Hi, beautiful. Yeah. Father, we just thank you for this beautiful gift of God. Father, I thank you, Lord, for this beautiful little girl. And Father, as we lay our hands on Gabriella, we speak the blessing of the Lord and the favor of God over her. God, for Ryan and Adriana as well, Father, we just lay our hands upon them and thank you for wisdom and understanding as they teach and train their child in the ways of the Lord. May the blessing of God rest upon him. Lord, may he stand as the priest in his home, and she is a woman that fears the Lord. And God, that your blessing would rest right here. Father, we bless this child today. We bless, Lord, the parents today. We bless the sisters today. And thank you, God, for all that you're doing. And pray for your grace and your goodness as well. Holy Spirit, we thank you.
Father, right now as we bless over beautiful baby Evelyn, Father, we're thankful for the joy that you've brought into Adam and Maggie's life. Another little one, Lord Jesus. We just speak blessings and favor over her, Father God, as she rises up to be the beautiful daughter, the princess that you've created her to be. We speak blessings and life over her, and Father, over Adam and Maggie and Jeremiah, the grandparents. You, Father, we're thankful for this home and your way.
Amen. Amen. Blessing and favor. God, I thank you. God, I just thank you. That's powerful. Thank you, Jesus. Wow. Father, we just thank you for little Micah, too. God, we thank you, Lord, for him and for Levi. And God, we just speak blessing and favor over the gift of God. Lord, we thank you. We call them the gift of God. And Father, we thank you for the blessing. Lord, I thank you for the blessing. I thank you for the restoration, God. I thank you for all that you're doing. You're doing amazing things in this family. And we celebrate, God. We celebrate your gifting. We celebrate, God, what you're doing. Father, I bless Craig and Rebecca today. And God, I speak life and blessing and favor over both of them as well. As they press in, God, to the destiny that you have for them. Father, I thank you. Lord, there's ministry in them and it will come forth. And God, I bless what you're doing in their lives. And I thank you, Father. And God, we just speak joy and peace over little Micah. Man, I just feel like, because I got to do this. Father, I just thank you for the prophetic voice in that child. God, I speak to the prophet within him. And Father, that even this will come forth. God, I thank you. I thank you, Lord, because his brothers are praisers. But God, I see him as a prophet. And Father, I thank you that your voice will be amplified through him. Use him, God. Even as a young child, he'll speak the things of God. He'll speak of the wonders of heaven. And Father, we declare and decree over him, God, prophet, arise. God, I thank you. Prophet, arise. Father, we see that. And I thank you, God, for gifting and favor and blessing in Jesus' name. Wow, thank you, God. Thank you, God. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Go ahead.
Father, right now we speak blessings over Gabriel, Lord. Oh, Father, he is such a joy.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, as he bounces around here from classroom to classroom and the hugs that he gives me every week, Father, I so look forward to. I speak right now blessings and favor over his life and joy and more hugs and just more times, Lord Jesus, that he soaks in you as he just learns, as he being taught, Father,
thank
by
you,
mother, by grandmother, by great-grandmother. Father, bless this home, Lord, and bless him in your name. Thank you, Jesus.
Wow. I just hear the Lord saying that there's angry birds on his ties, but the peaceful dove is in his heart.
Yes.
Holy Spirit, cover him. God, I thank you for a Holy Spirit covering. Holy Spirit just covering him right now. And I thank you, Lord, that this one will be a peacekeeper. Not a peacemaker, but a peacekeeper. There's a difference. And God, I just thank you for your hand resting upon him. God, that he's one that steps forward and isn't afraid and will lift up his voice and bring peace into tumultuous situations. God, I thank you that your anointing will rest upon him. And God, he'll be a peacemaker everywhere that he goes. I bless him in Jesus' name. Amen. Bless the Lord. Yeah. Hey, buddy. Wow. Man, I thank you for Isaac, Lord. God, I thank you, Lord, that even as Abraham offered Isaac as a gift on the altar, Lord, we see Isaac as a gift to you, to this family. And Father, we bless him today. And I thank you for the Spirit of the Lord resting upon him. God, I thank you, Lord, that even as he stays here on the platform taking a drink, God, he's going to be one that drinks of heaven. God, that he's going to drink of your Spirit. He's going to drink of your goodness. He's going to drink of your grace. And Lord, everything that he drinks, he will bring forth. So Father, I thank you for that. And I just bless him, Lord, that it'll nourish him and strengthen him. And he'll be a mighty warrior for God. So Father, we bless him as a warrior. God, that he'll stand strong in the Lord and the power of your might. Father, we bless him today. We thank you for this amazing family that surrounds him. And we just speak the blessing of the Lord over the entire group, God, that together, Lord, as we just celebrate all that you're doing, we're thanking you, God, because this is a beautiful gift. And Father, we see, Lord, the Spirit of God resting upon him. Lord, let him rise up, a mighty one for you, God. Father, one that's not afraid, one that's not ashamed, but God, he'll declare and decree your words and your truth. And Father, I thank you. Man, there's a warrior spirit in him. And God, I thank you for the warrior spirit, God. Lord, that even as he might be a little feisty now as a young one, he's going to be feisty in the Spirit. And in that place, God, amazing things are going to happen. So Father, I thank you. I thank you, Lord, for using him for the kingdom's sake. I thank you, God, for using him for your goodness and your glory. And Lord, that he would be one to lead many to the ways of Christ. God, that he will be one that will say, this is the way to walk. This is the path to take. And God, he'll be not afraid. There's leadership in him. Honey, I'm going to tell you something. There's leadership in this boy, and it's strong. I see that in the Spirit. Like, there's a strong leadership. He's not going to have somebody else tell him where to go or what to do. You probably already learned that. Okay? But that's because there's a strong leader inside of him. And he'll be one that'll have a voice, and he won't be afraid to use it. So, Father, we just prophesy over the leadership in Isaac, God, that he'll stand strong, and the power of God will rest upon him. And he'll be one, Lord, that will lead others in the path of righteousness, and he'll declare with his voice the goodness of God in the land of the living, and others will follow because of the anointing that rests upon him. So Father, I thank you. I'm reminded that Josiah was only 8 years old when he began to reign in Israel, and God, I see him reigning as a young man, stepping into the destiny that you have for him. And God, I thank you that it will only grow and increase over the years. So we bless him today in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Bless the Lord.
This time I'm going to ask all of you if you'll stand and join with us. Pastor Rick, will you come and pray a corporate blessing over the parents and grandparents and everyone here and the house to join in as we bless these babies.
We thank you, Lord, for trusting us with these lives, Lord God. And Lord, we take a vow today, Lord God, to do our very best to be an example and live a lifestyle, Lord God, that these children will follow after, Lord God. They'll learn from what we do, Lord Jesus. So, Lord, I pray, Holy Spirit, just come upon each and every person right now, Lord God. The parents, Lord God, the grandparents, those that are involved in the family, those that would directly, Lord God, be involved in their lives, Lord God, that they would train these children, Lord God, the way they should go, so when they grow old, they won't depart from it. We bless these families this day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Bless the Lord. She's going to hand you a certificate, I believe. As Pastor Lori's handing out certificates, it's a reminder to us of this day where we dedicated our children before the Lord. And it reminds us that even as we're all joined together in this moment, it's a place of just realizing, man, every one of us, through our actions, not just our voice, but through our actions, even play some role in helping these children to see Jesus. And that's got to be the cry of our heart, that they might see Jesus in us and desire the same. Amen. We good? Amen. Thanks for being with us, folks. Bless you. Okay. Huh? And the worship team's coming forward, and we're going to get right into worship. So let's go after Jesus this morning. Amen. Amen. I got you. prophesy over Gabe because she was pregnant, and the Lord was saying, you're pregnant with promises. The church was pregnant with promise, and a whole bunch of neat things happened in the first service, and we believed God for some things. I got to tell you, somebody who was in the first service who'd been desperately praying for a dear friend whose marriage was a mess got a text right after service about from the person who'd have no idea what was going on here because it's in completely another state, right? Like way far away. And that person said, I really feel like something changed this morning. Something shifted this morning. It's turning and shifting. Now, we prayed here and God touched there, right? Now, what happened, we just had Cheyenne getting baptized. And I know a lot of you don't know her story, but a couple of weeks ago, she got here from another state. And when she came, she's actually, she's had an amazing turturound. Like her whole life just shifted and changed. And right here is a prophetic symbol, right? What's it saying? Old things are passed away, all things become anew. And as we saw it, I said, Lord, that's awesome. He said, it's another prophetic prototype. It's another prophetic prototype. Old things were passing away in the tank. While that was happening, this is happening. God's doing amazing things. Old things are passing away, and God is making all things new. If you can understand, listen, you might have some old things that need to die today so that you can step into the new things that God has for you this afternoon. I'm going to tell you, this is a moment in time right now that's absolutely a Kairos moment. God will meet with you. If you've got some things right now that need to shift and change in your life, meet me up here. It's time to pray. We're going to believe God. Amazing things are happening. We're going to stay in an atmosphere of worship. But I'm telling you, there's something in the atmosphere right now. This is a life-changing day. God is doing amazing things. Yay, God. Worship. Let's just worship.
Baptize me with the Holy Spirit. Baptize me with fire. Baptize us in the Holy Spirit. Baptize us with fire. Baptize us in the Holy Spirit. Baptize us.
Holy, holy is the Lord.
today's your day. Today's the day. Let it be a day for you. Let it be a day of fresh starts. Let it be a day of redemption. Let it be a day. There's plenty of stuff back here. Plenty of stuff. Girls, there's all kinds of stuff for you. Guys, there's all kinds of stuff for you. There's plenty of changing rooms back here. There's plenty of towels back here. Don't miss the opportunity. Don't miss the time. Redemption. And what does that look like? Fresh starts. It is a new season. It's a new day. It's a new month. It's a new beginning. It's a new beginning. Don't miss your opportunity. Take a fresh dip. Old things are passed away. All things become new today in His glory. Who's ready? Who's ready? Who's ready? Who's ready? The pool is still open. Who's ready? Who's ready for that dip? Who's ready? Who's ready for a new touch? Who's ready? Who's ready for another dancing of His glory? Go ahead, Pam.
Shall I say? just honor the King of Glory. Let's just honor the King of Glory. Jesus, Jesus. Thank you. So come and consume, God, all we are. We give you permission, our hearts are yours. We want you. We want you. So come.
We want you. So come and consume. Sing.
as we bask in his presence. Dave spoke over KJ in the first service about the shower of the anointing of God. Scriptures talk about water, talk about living water, talk about washing away and cleansing us. We did baptisms, and he said, I want to saturate you. They were dunked. I want to saturate you in my blessings. I want to saturate you in my anointing. I want to saturate you in my healing. I want to saturate you in blessing. And so even the ones that didn't partake in the baptism are being blessed. This is church. And the Lord spoke to me and said, as we were doing the baptisms, they were dunked one way and came up as a new creation in Christ. Behold, all things were passed away, were made new. As the body of Christ, it's our responsibility to mentor these new baptisms, to pour into their lives, to bring them along, encourage them, edify them. And the last thing the Lord spoke to me is, they're now all in. They're all in the body of Christ.
Oh, you can be seated. Just basking in his presence. You never know, from service to service, from day to day, what you're going to get when you're his child. What gift is he going to give? What blessing? We sing blessings, honor, and favor, and he goes, we've always said we can't outgive God. This is what that means. You're here worshiping and singing praise and adoration and glory. And while we're doing that, he's gone, receive. He's saying, receive healing, receive restoration, receive forgiveness, receive love, receive mercy, receive blessing, receive redemption, receive the newness of life. What do you want? Because it's yours to receive whatever it is. Because you sang glory, honor, power. You sang holy, 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 worthy, worthy. Such a sweet savor in his nostrils in heaven that he reciprocated by pouring back out onto us, his children, in such love, in such beauty over here. I don't even know. I lost count after about 5, so I'm not even sure where we were. But it is such a beauty of watching old and life and the newness of what that means. So anytime you come into his house, into his presence, you know you can experience the very presence in your own car. Well, you better pull over. Just saying. But you can experience it in your living room, in your prayer room, in your bedroom, wherever you are, you can experience it because it comes through worship. It comes through worshiping Him and doing nothing but just singing glory to Him, singing praises to Him. You know, that's why we were created, right? We're created to glorify. We were created to worship Him and to honor Him. That's why we were created. We're created in just love and in just who He is. Wow. Okay. It's a little hard to switch gears. We'll try it for just a moment. So if you were in the first service, you might have a word or two you'd like to share. So get on up here. Come on. I see you. I know. But it's so cool because, you know, Daddy just does it. It's right there on the front seat, your microphones. It's a good time. We get to celebrate. Let's celebrate. Let's celebrate. Woo! The newness of life. The newness of life. Wow. I love celebrating who He is and who we are and who we are becoming. And it is just that impactful. Hi.
Hi.
Come here. You guys are going to tell us something, huh?
Yes, we are.
Okay. You going to tell us something, too?
We're going to be very brief.
It's
yes,
okay.
Because literally I'm one hallelujah away from being carried out of here. Oh, okay. Yes. Well, we just wanted to just tell you about our Dream Chasers Conference. It's going to be November 13th and 14th, and we're just inviting everyone out. It's specifically to 18 to 30, but I'm telling you, if you're out there and you have a dream inside of you that you haven't realized, don't go another year with your dream sitting on the shelf or in the closet. That's just step out here and just start chasing after it. I'll tell you, if you were in the first service, whew, I'm not usually a double dipper, but I'm telling you, you might want to start double dipping because I'm floating right now. But definitely, if you can come out, it is starts at
7 o'clock
November.
On Friday.
On a Friday, well, yeah. The 13th and 14th. So come on out and just let's go after it together.
That's it.
Yeah, they were a little more funnier in the first service, but I think they're a little drunk in the spirit up here right now. They can't seem to pull it off. So that's okay. Watch the online for the first service. So yeah. Go ahead.
Awesome. Well, cool. Well, I don't have my couple. Well, come on, Randy. Come over here. No, I'm just playing. But anyways, I thought we would do, instead of a husband and wife duel, we would just do a buddy duel, but he doesn't want to come out and play. So anyways, I just thought I'd dive really quick in, and I just wanted, as the community life pastor, I wanted to thank my church family for just all of the donations that you guys brought in for the past 2 months. The first month was peanut butter and jelly. You guys were really lucky. I had to be out and traveling because me and Jason were actually going to dress up peanut butter and jelly and do a little dance up here on the stage. So you are so lucky that me and Jason were the only radical ones that were actually going to jump up there in the costumes. And then last month, October, was cereal month. Man, we had like close to 200 boxes of cereal that we're able to reach out and bless New Hope Ministries with. So that's amazing. So God's groceries for New Hope Ministries this month is going to actually be, not peanut butter and jelly, sorry, I'm not going to dance for you, but it is going to be ketchup and mustard, okay? You go from the presence of God trying to now talk about food, but I know we're all excited about it. But anyways, is ketchup and mustard. You might be like, why in the world ketchup and mustard in November? Like, shouldn't we do something for, like, Thanksgiving? I'm going to get to that in just a second. But moms and dads and just single guardians, they can only afford hot dogs sometimes. And so how many of you know that ketchup and mustard, it just makes the hot dog taste a whole lot better? And really, it doesn't matter what time of the year, ketchup and mustard is like gold to a parent who can't supply their kids with much, okay? But what we are going to do to reach out and bless New Hope, what they're doing is they're going to be putting baskets together for Thanksgiving to give out to these parents. And I think that's awesome. And they've asked us if we can get a whole bunch of cans donated. They need like 300-400 cans of soup, okay? and we're going to try to get as much as we possibly can by November, all right? November 15th, and it's going to be chicken noodle soup. So if you guys can bring your cans of soup as well as ketchup and mustard, that would be absolutely amazing. This last thing, I'm not used to making this announcement, but I'm going to make it, and it feels really good. We are going to have loft service still for just a little bit. Pastor Don's still going to be preaching, so I'm going to be taking the youth upstairs from grades 7th through 12th, and we're going to, it's still 7th through 12th, right, Justin? All right, 7th through 12th. Just making sure, okay? 7th through 12th, and we're going to go upstairs in the loft, and I'm actually going to share a message with the youth, so I'm pretty excited about that. So bring your youth out. Come up. We're going to have a whole bunch of fun. Now, I'm going to introduce this next guy. He's going to do some announcements. He was my buddy that didn't want to come out and play earlier, but you all have to encourage my wife to sign up because she has a beautiful voice, and I think it would be absolutely amazing to see her a part of this choir that he's about ready to talk about. So how many of you would love to see my wife up there? I'll pay for it later, but thank you for your response.
You may be in trouble, buddy. I tried to ask her a couple of times and whatever. She's like, eh. We are going to get together a choir for a cantata for Christmas, and the sheet is out on the fellow in the center court to sign up. We have almost a full page. My goal is to have maybe 75 or 100 people in the choir. We will see. You guys in here, I know on any given Sunday morning, I'm usually with the headphones and the iPad and mixing the internet mix, but... And I know there's microphones in the ceiling here, and I know you folks sing. I know because I hear you. And so what I'm asking you to do is come out. We have some CDs we can give to you for practice or whatever. You can drive it down the road in your car. You can throw it in and listen to it and practice with the whole choir, and there nobody else is in the car with you. Anyways, sign up outside and just check with me.
Outside?
Out in the center.
Randy, it's still a little too cold to be signing up outside. I don't really want to go outside. Randy.
She's so bad. Anyways, we're going to be practicing Wednesday evenings from 7:30 to almost 9-ish. We'll try to keep you good for you there. If it's not cleared out in this particular room, we may go over into Fellowship Hall, but we'll be having practice, okay? Thanks a lot.
Hey, awesome, yeah. No, I. Do you want me, does that one look better with my outfit or something? You want me to do? Hey, how many Pell Lunch did we do? We did 92 lunches on Wednesday for the Pell Lunch. All right, woo! And how many came out? And we had 14 servers. Thank you, family, for coming out on Wednesday and helping with our Pell Lunch. We had a few newbies this time. So it is a fun time to come out on Wednesday mornings and help out at the mission with the Pell Lunches and just getting to serve the food, cook the food, love on the people, pray with the people. It's just another area of things that you are doing to make a difference in our community. Thanks, Bobby Joe, for heading that up. Wow, okay. I forget what I'm supposed to do. Is this a little, yeah, you should be up here. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. Thank you. If you are a first-time visitor in our house, we have a gift for you at the end of service, not outside. It's actually at the Welcome Center. So if you are a first-time visitor, we would like to welcome you. And if you raise your hand very quickly, our greeters will get to you and give you a welcome packet. And you can pick up your free gift at the end of service over there. And so keep your hands up very high until they get to you, because they may not see you over this way, guys. Okay, just to make sure, because sometimes with the stage lighting, it does get a little bit way in the back that way too. So there you go. Just keep them up until someone finally gets to you. John, the other way. There you go, back that way. There you go. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Yeah, services for our first-time visitors are not always quite like this, but you never know when you're coming into the Father's house. You know, I mean, it's like when you're going out in the world, when you're going to a football game, when you're going to shopping or wherever you're doing everything. We never know what we're going to, and that's a good thing. So if you thought you were coming and you were going to get, you know, a regimented kind of thing, I'm sorry. We're just family here. And we just love to hear the presence of the Lord.
Cool.
And just to bask in that.
How many know today's been a very significant day? Thank you for your patience. And I think it's awesome. It's your fault, Cheyenne. You started this. Okay. But amazing things happening. Can I share? Like, there's just so many cool things. You need to know this. You're part of something bigger, you know, because everybody wants to be a part of something bigger. And I think it's really awesome. Last week, we mentioned one of the girls that's on with us all the time is Miranda. She does a lot of the piano playing, singing, different things, right? And we were sending her to Salem, Massachusetts. If you were in the service, I think we prayed for her. We were sending her to Salem, Massachusetts. Listen, last night was crazy. God gave me at least 70 to 80 prophetic words. Every one of them, the people said that it was or is what they were going through. It was amazing. Healings everywhere. Just an